Hello, my dear students. This is Dr. Satish Polchettiwar from MIT World Peace University School of Pharmacy, Pune, India. In today's lecture, we will talk about the automation, machine learning and robotics. That is, we commonly call as artificial intelligence in pharma industry. That is the future of pharma industry. Okay, so we'll begin with this topic. So what you're going to discuss in today's lecture, the first we'll talk about what is pharmaceutical automation, what is artificial intelligence, then how it works, then we'll discuss about components, then process overview, then what are different emerging technology that are being used in pharmaceutical industry to make the system automated and continuous things. Then we'll discuss about the benefits of machine learning and robotics in pharma industries. Then what are the challenges with this system? Then we'll take one or two case studies. Then also we'll discuss the future of AI, that is artificial intelligence. And finally, we'll conclude this session. So let us continue with this topic, why it is necessary. Okay, why we need to study this robotics, why we need to study this artificial intelligence. Okay, so all of you know nowadays the pharmaceutical industries are moving very fast. Okay, they need a solution very fastly. Okay, we cannot wait for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years to bring the technology into markets. Okay, so for that we need to adopt the new technologies to bring and to come up with the quality products with a specified time period, with minimization of cost and time. Okay, that is the fundamentals of pharmaceutical industries. Okay, so that is the things that you are going to learn. Okay. If you understood the global pharmaceutical industry scenario, it has traditionally been a very complex and difficult space to master. Okay, so tasked with serving the health needs of millions of patients with varied affliction of the industry must constantly meet a stringent regulation and compliance the standards. All of you nowadays, we use the QBD. Without QBD, your product won't get license, won't get permissions to move further. Okay, so nowadays the industry are used the some software tools or computational tools to make the system more feasible, more stringent. Okay, the pharmaceutical manufacturing has evolved drastically since the days of apothecary carries, okay, and wholesale production in 19th century. Today drug maker have if you see the state of art manufacturing facilities that are driven by a robotic system or AI system, that is artificial intelligence. Then cutting edge technologies enable business process, okay, in alignment with the GMP, good manufacturing practice, as per US FDA regulations. Okay, the recipe process now go through multiple automated stage as the industry transition from batch to continuous manufacturing. Now the era has come to make the continuous manufacturing, okay, with minimum manpower. That is very important. Okay, so what is automation exactly? So automation means use of machine or equipment for performing physical mental operation in production process in place of human being. Okay, in a system of doing work where material handling, production process and product design are integrated through mechanism of thoughts and efforts to achieve a set of regulating and controlling systems, is the result of industrialization driven by need to increase productivity and to achieve a consistent quality products. That is the motto of any pharmaceutical industry. We need to produce the quality products. So it can be done by various level of manufacturing systems, that we can handle the raw materials, semi-finished goods or finished goods during production process. We make the system more efficient by using machine, inspection process, quality control process. Okay, this make a system very very easy, and we can get a quality results without doing without any error. Okay, so we can minimize the error through automation process, as well as we can reduce the cost and time also. Then another term that is a very buzzword nowadays, we use artificial intelligence. Okay, this is nothing but a machine learning. We need to understood algorithm, we need to understood the RPA, robotic process automation. Means artificial intelligence is being increasingly overused even with low level automation. This lead to the capabilities of being confused between technologies of their subset, like AI, ML, robotic process automation, that is RPA. Okay, RPA mimic the human thinking by performing a string of tasks fed up in the system. So AI will give the input through certain software. Robotic system will work on that AI system. Okay, this is called as integration of this AI and robots, so as to get your work done it very fastly and with quality. Okay, so goal of all this intermediary development is to create a software which mimic the human ability to make a decision, logic deduction, and act accordingly. So automation means self-dictated. So already we discussed these things. Okay, automation greatly reduces the need for human sensor and mental requirement, as well as we can make the system more automated and we can make it continuous. So what is the goal of automation? So productivity isn't the goal of only goal of this automation. Okay, we are not going to increase the production. So we need to improve the quality. We need to improve the quality of the products in order to reduce the risk, reduce the failure, reduce the your cost and time also. That is the very important things. Okay, there are many goals such as getting a lot more done with existing resources, reducing mistakes, improving safety, free up the human so that can focus on higher value work. Okay, because without human being we cannot go ahead. That even automation is there, but we need to give the feedback, we need to give some inputs, so that for that human being is required, human minds is required. Without that we cannot work. Okay, so quicker response time when problem arises, the feeling of being understood, then timely we can take follow up, we can just set the parameter accordingly that the system will work, no need to wait for 12 hours. Okay, just you set the parameter only, then we can monitor the system through that software tools. We can anticipating the future needs and inquiries to comply with regulatory guidelines also. Nowadays if you heard that many product getting fail in US market because of data integrity, because of manipulation of these things. Okay, data integrity is one of the biggest problem in pharma industry. So that we can also minimize, that we can also reduce. Okay, so we can your product get easily get license, easily your regulatory agency will grant the permission for your drugs, your formulations within that specified period. Okay, stipulated period of time. So understanding technology for smarter automation implementations. This is simply one example, thermostat control. Okay, so what will happen? The thermostat control the temperatures. Okay, if temperature goes as per your setting value, okay, so it will automatically bring down that normal, that selected systems. Okay, getting as per your need, you can maintain the temperature and you can monitor, that system will monitor throughout the entire process. That is the we can say beauty or one of the advantages of this automations and robotic system in pharma industries. Okay, this is the kind of heat exchanger we use in fan, thermostatic systems. In AC we use that system. Okay, in your hot air oven we use, in your autoclave we use this system. Means the nowadays this artificial intelligence are used in various purposes. Okay, so what are advantages of this system? Automatic control over manual control, process are controlled more precisely, resulting in more uniform high quality products. Process are too fast to be controlled by manual operator, can be easily controlled by automatic systems. Then automatic control are very beneficial in certain remote, hazardous and routine operation. Automatically it will lock down system. Okay, you can set the parameter, if you go temperature goes above that, automatically it will shut down. Okay, what is that system? That is called as automated system. Automation, yeah, artificial intelligence we can use. Okay, you can make automatic doors by your sensing at door will be open. Okay, you can control the door and all these things. Okay, no batch to batch variation also. If you produce the batch, okay, next batch also you will get same similar characteristics. Means lead to greater demand for product and higher profit you can get. Increase production capabilities and flexibility. Means capability of production also increase and we can the system make more flexible and decrease the labor cost also. Okay, cost of labor also, because industry also focusing on reducing cost, so it could be available to the common public at very affordable rates. That is also very important. Okay, so automation in pharma industry, basic purpose of automation is to increase the productivity, improve the quality of products, reduce the waste, reduce the cost for safe handling hazardous substance, to take heavy work from worker. Regulation is major consideration for automation as it ensures the compliance with safety consideration and other guidelines. So what is the classification of industrial and laboratory automation? It could be process automation and discrete automation. Process means deals with the handling of raw material in the form of such liquid, powder. If you want to pass the liquid to one stage to another stage in the oil refinery process, in gas refinery process, chemical industry, you need to do the continuous automation. Continuously you have to supply your raw material to the fermenter, yeah, any other systems. Okay, discrete means essentially deals with the assembly of part requiring high level of mechanical motion to produce consumer electronics product for the automotive industries. Okay, So what are the advantages? So already we discussed the advantage of this system, okay, to get a better quality products, direct labor, reduce the labor cost, effective control in operation. We discussed already these points, okay. So drawback, because every system has certain drawbacks, okay. So a lot of ambiguity and a lot of debates are going on whether this AI system will reduce the that means directly impact on unemployability and all these things, okay. This is not a true, okay. If you see the other sides, okay, advantages are more than disadvantages. So what are disadvantages of this system? Huge capital investment is required. That is very important because you have to adopt the all sophisticated system that need to be, you have to purchase that things are very costly. The maintenance cost is very high because maintenance labor are higher caliber is required. It can create a unemployment. That is the problem. Okay. Yeah. A continuous power supply is required for the system. Because if you want to make the system continuous, you have to give continuous supply. Then large inventor are required. Any breakdown anywhere would lead to complete shutdown the system because you need to have that expert system to resolve that issue if anything happened with that system. Require highly skilled manpower. There are restrictions in designing and construction of building also. Because earlier we have designed the system as per our basic things, our fundamental things. Okay, now if you improve the system, if you want to add the other system, they need to be designed accordingly. So process automation system applies in the primary manufacture of API, active pharmaceutical ingredients. Both process and discrete automation are applied in the secondary manufacturing of formulation and packaging, like compounding, filling, washing, leveling machine and packing system. Okay, in the pharma industry, we use this automation system for continuous packaging system, continuous manufacturing system, continuous filling system. We can do all these things, okay, with this hybrid system. This is one case study. Nowadays, if you heard about the spray dryer, which is mostly used to dry your products to get a porous substance, to increase solubility and to increase stability of the drugs, we need to make it. You can use this spray dryer. In this technique, liquid is sprayed or atomized in the drying chamber, in which air or inert gas driven off the solvent, typically water. Mostly water is used. Okay. Then ensuring the desired properties of this material require choosing the appropriate atomization technology by optimizing the range of process. We can set the parameter according to your need and you can get the products, okay, accordingly. This process can be done fully automatic way. Okay, nowadays the automatic spreader are also available where it works automatically completely. Okay, only you have to give some inputs. You have to set the temperature, inlet temperature, outlet temperature, flow rate. Okay, so entire thing you can just manage with that software, and that software is called as AI system, artificial intelligence, that give the input to that robots we call as the machineries, okay, who that means in the drying chamber. Okay, got it. So what is the process outcome of this spray drying process? To increase the process stability, above all reach constant product quality. Batch to batch variation is very very less. We can minimize that, okay, because see, this system work automatically. Just you set the parameter, system will work accordingly. So automation are the key, first key we can say, a step to help manufacturer head in this direction and deliver the best medicines. So advantage of spray dryings, we already discussed all this part, okay. Then another case study is automation in tablet industry. In tablet manufacturing, the various steps involved, starting from pre-formulations to your packaging, okay, you have to improve the material handling system, improve the specific unit operation like particle size reduction, sieving, mixing, particle size enlargement, drying, compression, sorting, coating, packing, then elimination and combining of this process steps, then incorporate the automated process control of unit operation and process. We can use this automated system in order to get your product as per the desired quality, okay. So example of material handling improvements, no human handling materials are required. You can use some equipment like Merck Sharp Dohme, Ilili company machines are there, which is called as Doensa mixers, okay, which works on automatically. Just you have to set the parameter, okay. This will give the continuous batch mixing without we can say any error, okay. Same coating also we use Axela Coata to get uniformity in your products. It is also a continuous process. Only you have to need to just. Thank you very much.